Thank you. So the subject is social media and young people. I'd like to hear your thoughts as to how young people that want to excel, want to be a winner, want to be perhaps even the best, give them some tools to cope with social media, because I, as a coach, see social media as one of the biggest challenges to my young athletes trying to be their best.
Thank you both. Happy anniversary, Hollowbrook.
Awesome.
This is fantastic. This is a question about parenting. Very unique sport, right? I mean, the economic barrier to entry is incredible. So we talk about how do you get that fight for kids that maybe have tremendous privilege and parents have safety nets all over the place for them. And as I look at the greats in U.S. riding, they didn't come from that, right? They were fighters who had grit and just made it work when they had nothing. And I look at the next generation coming up, and it's a very different situation because of that economic barrier. So just advice for parents who are trying to fuel that fight in a world that is a bubble, that is not reality in terms of the economic situation.
I'm going to
Thank you. What a great conversation today. Thank you for sharing all these different insights. So I have a two-part question. One is, how do you prepare for those moments? You know, there's that old saying that the moment either defines the person or the person defines the moment. And we can all talk about the training and falling back on your training. That being said, what I read a lot about, and as I read about it, I thought about some different things that I did in my life. And I want to know if you have an alter ego that you use when you get into that moment in the ring. You know, whether it's Kobe Bryant and the Black Mamba, or it's Bo Jackson, or it's Beyonce, they all talk about how they can't necessarily deal with all the emotion in the moment. And they create these alter egos that help them and rise them above to another level when they get into those situations.
Thank you. remember this, but the first time I met Bob, I went to see him at his place in North Palm Beach. And I walked in and I knew I was dealing with a super professional because the first thing he said to me was, I just spent the last 5 hours watching every single video of you riding on YouTube. I spent 5 hours studying your ride. And he said, the first thing I can tell you is, try when you ride to think about being unconscious competent, not conscious competent. Can you talk a little bit about that? Because it's a
I'm going to go to the hospital.